Let's discuss the electric field due to a uniformly charged non-conducting long cylinder. As the figure shows, a long cylinder of radius r, which is uniformly charged in its volume with the volume charge density rho coulomb per meter cube. And here say we are required to find the electric field strength in its surrounding. And this situation for outside region, that is say at a point for x greater than r. At a point P, we are required to find the electric field by using Gauss law. Then we consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface, which you can see here. In this diagram, you can see now, this is the Gaussian surface M, which we have considered. And it is a cylindrical surface, which is passing through the point P, where we are required to find the electric field. And to apply Gauss law on this Gaussian surface, say it is of length L. We first split it into three parts, 1, 2 and 3. And in this situation, we know that the total electric flux passing through the Gaussian surface, it can be given as for outside points using Gauss law at the surface M. Here we can give integration for the closed surface E dot ds will be net enclosed charge by epsilon naught. And this situation, this enclosed charge can be given by the portion of cylinder which is enclosed by the Gaussian surface, which is having a volume pi r square L because it is of length L. So it can be written as rho multiplied by pi r square L by epsilon naught. And this integral, as we already discussed in the previous section, that this integral for part 1 and 3 will vanish and only 2 will be left over. So it can be written as E integration of ds for the section 2 is equals to rho pi r square L by epsilon naught. And the integral of this element ds will be the surface area of the lateral surface, which can be given as E into 2 pi r L, which is equals to rho pi r square L by epsilon naught. Here you can see this pi and L gets cancelled out and the value of electric field we can get is rho r square by 2 epsilon naught r. And here you can also write it as rho r square by 2 epsilon naught x. As I've already taken x less than r, so here small r can be replaced by x. That is the electric field in the outside region of a long cylinder of radius r, which is charged with a uniformly volume charge density rho coulomb per meter cube. Now in continuation, if we discuss for points which are inside the cylinder, that is x less than r. So if we consider a point P inside the cylinder at a distance x from its axis, and we are required to find the electric field at point P, then in this situation we consider a Gaussian surface which is inside the cylinder, and say it is also of length L, and we apply Gauss law on the surface M. And if we use Gauss law for the surface M, then we need to find out the enclosed charge within this region, which is of length L. So here Q enclosed can be given as rho multiplied by the volume of this Gaussian surface, which is pi x square L. Now in this situation, if we use, we can write using Gauss law for surface M. Here also we can write integration of E dot ds for the Gaussian surface M will be equal to the enclosed charge by epsilon naught, which is rho pi x square L by epsilon naught. And in this situation also for the surface M, if we split it in three parts, the only integral which will be through the lateral surface of the cylindrical Gaussian surface will left over, because E dot ds for section 1 and section 3 will vanish due to the reasons we already discussed in the previous section. So it will be integration of E dot ds, and due to uniformity we can take this electric field out. E ds for the lateral surface is equal to rho pi x square L by epsilon naught, and this will be E multiplied by this total surface area will be 2 pi xL and this equals to rho pi x square L by epsilon naught. Now in this situation pi x and L will get cancelled out. So here electric field we can directly write as rho x by 2 epsilon naught, which is a result we already discussed in the section of electrostatics in the beginning. But now we have calculated the electric field inside a uniformly charged long cylinder at a distance x from the central axis, which is given as rho x by 2 epsilon naught. Just keep the result on your tips.